Nautilus is GNOME's default file manager application, and you may have seen it in many Linux distributions. It's a good file manager with plenty of features. However, you can enhance your experience by employing some tweaks and tips. Hey folks, I'm Abhishek from itsforce.com, and I'm going to share such tips and tweaks in this video. Some tweaks may require installing additional Nautilus plugins, while some are built-in but lesser known to people. A few tips are purely cosmetic and just change the look and feel, and some could enhance your productivity. The first tip is to show the number of items in folders. You can show how many files and folders are inside a folder in the file explorer, and it will be right under the name of the folder. You don't need to install any plugins for it. It's a built-in feature. Go to Preference in Nautilus, and then under Icon View Captions, set the first place to Size. That's about it. The second tip is adding New Document Creation option in right-click context menu. This is a feature that can increase your productivity. Right-click on an empty place inside a folder, and it should show you the option to create a new empty text file or even LibreOffice document. It was removed from GNOME a few years back, and it is making a comeback in the next GNOME release. To achieve this, you need to create an empty file and name it New Document or anything you want. Then save this file to the templates directory to get it in the right-click context menu. After this, you should see the option in the right-click context menu. Talking of right-click context menu, you can also add the permanent delete option. By default, Nautilus provides move to trash option in the right-click context menu. If you want to permanently delete a file or folder, you need to use the shift delete or empty it from the trash. You can enable this delete permanent button under the right-click context menu from the Nautilus preferences. Speaking of permanently deleting a file, well, the last method doesn't really delete the files permanently. They could still be recovered. Nautilus provides an extension to wipe files securely and fill the empty places so that the data cannot be recovered anymore. For this, you need to install nautilus-wipe extension and then restart the file explorer. Now you should see the wipeout option in the right-click context menu. The next feature is file preview. Quick preview is rather a handy feature for a file manager. KDE's Dolphin file manager provides it as a built-in feature. You can preview files such as PDF, text, images, audio, etc. And you can also scroll documents while in the preview mode. In Nautilus, you need to install gnome-sushi extension to get this feature. Install the extension and close all the running instances of file manager and open it again. To see the preview, select a file and press the space key. Another built-in feature which many people are not aware of is the list of recently visited directories. You can access it from the top left, and you can either long left click it or right click on the back arrow button, and it will show all the previously visited folders. If you frequently access some folders, it would be better to access them from the left sidebar quickly. It's quite simple actually. Select the folder and drag and drop to the left sidebar. The folder will be added as a bookmark. You can remove the bookmark the same way. Just drag and drop it from the sidebar. Another right-click context menu tip. You can add the option to rotate and resize images from the right-click context menu. For this, you need to install imagemagick and nautilus-image-converter extension. Once these packages are installed, quit Nautilus and reopen it. Now select an image and right click to get the resize and rotate image option. The next step is purely cosmetic and adds some color. Actually, it changes the colors of the folders. For this, you need to install folder color extension and then quit Nautilus. And when you reopen it, you should see the folder color option and you can choose the folder color you want. And you can change the color you want. Since we are speaking of changing the color of directories, why not change the icon itself? This one actually takes me back to the Windows XP era. Nautilus also has the built-in feature to change the icons of selected directories. To do that, right-click on a folder and go to Properties. From there, select the icon, browse, and choose the image of your choice. The next little trick is for the people who like using Terminal. Wherever you are in the File Explorer right now, you can open the location in the Terminal directly. And in fact, don't need to install anything or any extension. It's a built-in feature and it's present right there in the right-click context menu. This feature comes in handy when you have to do something in the Terminal on the files in a particular location. It saves the effort of typing a long path. Next tweak is opening files and folders as root from the file manager. You sometimes want to paste files to restricted directories like user share backgrounds. You cannot paste such locations or cannot edit such files unless you are root or use sudo. You can do this in Terminal, but well, not everyone is comfortable with that. With Nautilus admin extension, you can open files as root within Nautilus. No need to open the terminal and perform sudo actions. It gives you the option from the comfort of the graphical user interface. The next tip is about verifying the checksum of files in the file manager. If you download files from the internet like ISO of other distributions, you can verify their checksum right in the file manager with the help of Nautilus GTK hash extension. Install the extension, select the file to check hash, and go to Digests tab in Properties. Now enter the hash to check. And press hash, it will start calculating the hash. After some time, it will show the result. Green tick mark means the hash is valid. Alright, I'll throw a bonus tip for the people who love Terminal. In the Nautilus file manager, you can embed a terminal. Each time you change directories, a CD command is initiated and the location in the embedded terminal is also changed. Actually, installing it requires getting several Python packages first, and this is why not many people would like to use it. But if it is something that excites you, you can find the commands in the description to use it to get a terminal embed right in your file manager. There are many more Nautilus extensions and tweaks, and it is not possible for me to list them all, because there is no end to customizing the file manager or customizing the Linux desktop in general. I have shared my favorites with you. Now, did you find any interesting tweaks that you will be using? Why not mention it in the comments? And do you know any extra tweaks that you're proud of? Why not share it within the comments as well? If you like the video, do subscribe for more desktop Linux videos. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.